As last part of this week's session, we will talk about the international regional cooperation structures in the field of spectrum management. The need for regional agencies was that some countries, in some cases, feel the need to form regional alliances because of they have to perform significant cross-border alignments to avoid interference. They believe that they can have a greater influence at the World Radio Conference, and they find it useful to share information and perhaps management systems and software. They have varying degrees of power and resource. In the CPT, via the European Communication Office, which has substantial manpower and finances. They generally have limited legal status. They cannot replace the role of the national agency and regulator or formal directorate. An overview of the various regional structures. To begin with the APT, the Asia Pacific Telecommunity comprises 32 member states, along with associate members and affiliates. It commenced its activities in 1979 and has a mandate to develop regional cooperation in areas of common interest, including radio communications and standards development. The APT works to harmonize the views of its member states on radio spectrum use and management. Also on harmonization of WRC proposals, which is undertaken through a preparatory group, the APG. Then we talk about the ASMG, the Arab Council of Ministers for Telecommunication and Information, is the supreme organ in the League of Arab States, dealing with telecommunication, information and postal services for the Arab world. It has 21 member states of the League. The Council created permanent committee and permanent groups for different activities, and one of them is the Arab Spectrum Management Group, the ASMG. Something about the African Telecommunication Union. Founded in 1977 as a specialized agency of the African Union. The African Telecommunication Union, ATU, took its present name in 1999. ATU provides a forum for stakeholders to formulate effective policies and strategies aimed at improving access to information, infrastructure and services. The mission of the Union is to promote the rapid development of info communications in Africa in order to achieve universal access and full inter-country connectivity. The ATU currently has 44 member states and 16 associate members. As a remark, can be said that some of the members of the African Telecommunication Union are also members of the Arab League of Countries. The CEPT was established in 1959 and now has 48 member countries. The Electronic Communications Committee, the ECC, of the CEPT considers and develops policies on electronic communication activities in the European context. The CEPT also has the European Communications Office, the ECO, which provides advice and support to CEPT to help it to develop and deliver its policies and decisions in an effective and a transparent way. Within Europe, we also have the European Union. The European Union has a remit for spectrum policy from the radio spectrum decision adopted by the Council and the European Parliament in March 2002. The decision establishes a cooperation mechanism through the Radio Spectrum Committee to address mandates to CEPT on the harmonization of frequency use. The Radio Spectrum Committee has the status of a committee of member states and is chaired by the European Commission under the spectrum decision. Furthermore, there is a consultative group, the Radio Spectrum Policy Group, which was established under a separate commission decision with a representation of high-level governmental experts from member states. In addition to the regulation on communication services, the EU has adopted the RNTTE directive, making the free circulation of such equipment mandatory. The RNTTE directive also imposes the publication of information on radio interfaces and national frequency allocation tables. Although the directive applies only to equipment, it imposes a high degree of harmonization among EU countries. The European Union finalized the establishment of a regulatory framework for strategic planning and the harmonization of spectrum use within the Union, and with a number of objectives. Then about CTEL, the Inter-American Telecommunication Commission, an entity of the Organization of American States, is the main forum in which the governments and the private sector meet to coordinate regional efforts to develop the global information society. Under the auspices of the Organization of American States, the CETEL resides in Washington and has 35 member states and over 200 associate members. In the Americas, we also have the Eastern Caribbean Telecommunication Authority, which has 5 Eastern Caribbean states. It provides an online searchable database of allocations of the member states of ECTEL. And then something about the HEM agreement in Europe. It is an example of cooperation at the regional level. It is designed to reduce interference across border areas between a range of neighboring countries, which are indicated in blue on the map of Europe. It started in 1956 as an agreement between Belgium, the Netherlands and Germany relating to fixed and mobile services in border areas, based on an exchange of frequency lists between the three countries. To summarize, most countries are members of a regional spectrum organization. These differ, reflecting the needs of the region. And like the ITU, none have any powers over member states, except for the EU, which is not really a regional spectrum management organization, but have power on the member states of the EU being part of the CEPT. Ad hoc agreements between collections of neighboring countries also can be used to help resolve interference. And this is the end of week number 2. And again, some work to be done by you. The reference for study material are again shown in the presentations you have received. And again, you are asked to actively participate in the forum discussion and chat session this week and respond to the questions you will receive at the end of the week. And again, wishing you a lot of success. Thank you very much.